Let's hear a Hosanna for the Lord this morning.
Hosanna, yeah.
Great to see you all. It's good to see you again. Good morning. Several things to alert you to happening this week and in the coming weeks. It's coming Tuesday, Women's Prayer Online will be occurring at 6 p.m. And Wednesday, April Fool's Day, at 6:30, we'll have our men's study at the Very Cool Springs. We will be there. It's not a joke, right? Yeah, no fooling. We'll be there. Just be prepared for those ongoing ministries. This coming Friday, we're going to have a Good Friday service. It's at 5:30. Our brother Mark Leventhal is going to lead us in a traditional Passover Seder for dinner. Anybody who'd like to take part in that, if you're not familiar with Passover the Seder, I'd encourage you to look at Exodus chapter 12. It describes in full what this meal is, what it became, what it represents. And we're going to experience that ourselves as a church body this Friday. So there's a sign-up sheet in the back right by the table where the Bibles are if you'd like to be a part of that. There's a cooking and food component, and we'd also just like to know how many people are going to be there for purposes of mission. So we'd encourage you to be there for that this coming Friday at 5:30 p.m. Of course, our Resurrection Sunday service will be Sunday, April 5th, 10 a.m. regular time. So we encourage you all to be out for that. And as we've mentioned the last couple weeks, our women's conference is going to be April 10th through 11th. And we really encourage all the ladies to sign up for that. We really need to have everyone signed up by next week. You can do that online. It costs us $45. Again, we just really like to stress that we'd love to have the ladies out there for that event. And along those lines, today, right after the service, there's going to be a work party. Any of the ladies who would like to attend, there's going to be some ongoing work in preparation for that conference. It's going to be right here, right after the service. If there's enough ladies, we're going to have lunch provided. So just encourage you to stick around for that right after the service. And in case y'all haven't known or haven't been there in a while, you can find all these things posted to our website. It's calvarychapelfranklin.com on a weekly basis. So check the website out if you want to stay in touch as well. All right, so keep all those things in mind this week. But this morning, as we prepare to worship, let's all stand together. If you have your Bibles, open them with me to Psalm 118. Psalm 118, and we're not going to have the scripture on the screen behind me this morning, so you may have different translations, but I would encourage you to read along with me. I'm going to read verses 19 through 29 as we prepare for worship. So that's Psalm 118, verses 19 through 29. Psalm 118, beginning in verse 19. The psalmist says, "Open to me the gates of righteousness. I will go through them, and I will praise the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord, through which the righteous shall enter. I will praise you, for you have answered me, and have become my salvation. The stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This was the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Save now, I pray, O Lord. O Lord, I pray, send now prosperity. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We have blessed you from the house of the Lord. God is the Lord, and he has given us light. Bind the sacrifice with cords to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, I will exalt you. We give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever." Pretty much says it all, doesn't it? Let's pray. Father, this morning we do just give you thanks, Lord, that your mercy endures forever. Father, that you have made that way of salvation, that you have made it known to us, Lord, that we can walk through those gates. Father, that we can choose to follow our son Jesus, Lord, that all of our sins can be forgiven, and we can be made new. Lord, we just praise you for this great work you've done. Lord, we remember 2,000 years ago, the start of this week that changed history forever. Father, help us to celebrate this morning he who came in the name of the Lord. And Father, be with us now. This time is meant for you. And Father, we just lift it up to you. Lord, lead us during this time. Go before us. And Lord, we just love you and we thank you. Be with us now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Very good to us. Listen to worship this morning. Hear our voices.
Our God, you reign forever. Our Lord, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. You do thank you. Give us pure hearts.
those things in our hearts that have become idols, that become stumbling blocks to you taking the throne fully and completely. We sing these words and we just want them to be a reality in our lives. And so show us those things that need to be surrendered and take hold of us entirely. We desire to worship you and to bless you.
Thank you.
Bless this time as we look at Jesus, as we consider him. Help us to see him clearly. And help us to be more like him. It's in his great name that we ask these things. And all God's people say. Amen. And good morning once again. Why don't you take a moment and say hello to somebody around you?